Foundation is obviously, it's informed and inspired by two historical pillars, one being the Nichi Bei Shimbun, which was formed in 1899 by Kyutaro Abiko, said to be the most influential Issei pioneer. Not only did he create the Nichi Bei Shimbun in 1899, but he also founded three Japanese farming colonies in the Central Valley, a bank program to send Nisei to Japan to learn more about their culture during the summer. And after he passed away in 1936, it was taken over by Yona Abiko, his wife, who is the younger sister of Umeko Tsuda, the founder of Tsuda College in Japan. Yona Abiko also founded was a chief fundraiser for the Japantown, or Japanese YWCA, which is now home to Nihonmachi Little Friends. After the war, some former staff members of the Nichi Bei Shimbun started the Nichi Bei Times to get the community reconnected after their devastating wartime experience in the concentration camps. They found the Nichi Bei Times as a way to get the community reconnected, and the leader of that movement was Shichinosuke Asano. The Times was started as a corporation, different from a sole proprietorship, which was what the Shimbun was. But Mr. Asano was a protege of the first commoner prime minister of Japan, Takashi K. Hara, who told him to go to America and make something of himself. So Mr. Asano used the early pages of the Nichi Bei Times to help guide this movement for post-war relief. And so you have 17 tons of products that were sent out here from America, and 20% of those were done by Japanese American groups and Japanese South American groups after the war, using different relief societies. So the Nichi Bei Times in those early stages was used to send those post-war relief goods to Japan, because although Japanese Americans came out of camp with nothing, Mr. Asano and others knew that those in Japan were even more devastated because of the war and starving, so they sought responsibility to send relief goods to Japan. The Nichi Bei Times board of directors was closing the newspaper in 2009. And to counter that, we started the Nichi Bei Foundation, technically July 27, 2009. And this was something really uncharted. It was uncharted waters. There was no model to go by. So essentially, we're starting this nonprofit organization to start the first nonprofit ethnic newspaper of its kind in the country, the Nichi Bei Weekly. Again, there's no model to go by, so we're, the beginning of that was very tumultuous. But it was important to me to have the first edition of the Nichi Bei Weekly follow the very last issue of the Nichi Bei Times. So there was this continuity, and we did so because we felt the community needed a news resource, a means to keep people connected. And then a month later, the Hokubei Mainichi closed. The mission of the Nichi Bei Foundation, and by extension the Nichi Bei Weekly, is to keep the Japanese American, Asian American community connected, informed, and empowered. Very simple. I think also because of the times, the economic reality of when we were born, our mission has expanded to helping other community organizations through publication of their events, sponsorship ads of fundraising events. And I also see a large part of our role is documenting history as it happens. There's really no other newspaper doing that now. And as we've seen by the researchers who came to do research on the old Nichi Bei Shimbun, Nichi Bei Times, in 50, 100 years from now, the only thing that's going to indicate the life of the community is going to be the community newspaper. TV is not going to be indexed. Radio is gone one ear and out the other over the commercial break. And we don't know where the internet's going to be like. So what we're doing is documenting history as it happens. And I think that has become a large part of our role. And I think it's one of the awesome responsibilities that we have. Now, we also have done things to empower the community, like we have a Northern California Cherry Blossom Festival and Japanese Culture Guide, which this has morphed into a guide, the only, from what I know, the only guide in the country on Japanese culture on an annual basis. So not only do we have description, bilingual Japanese English of all the cultural arts, but we have a growing list of where people can take those classes. And in that way, I think we're helping to reinvigorate interest in cultural arts by providing people the means to practice them in case they are interested. With that, we also have this Japantown map and directory of San Francisco's Japantown, and it's different from what the merchants may put out that highlights the merchants only, but we have every single business community organization in Japantown and vicinity, even on the outskirts, and we list them in a bilingual directory and we put them on the map. And I think this helps to empower those organizations and those businesses as well. We also do the only Obon and Summer Festivals guide. So we have a guide to all the Obon and Summer Festivals in the country. And we send that to all the churches in the Japanese American community, the markets, community centers as well. One thing that we did in 2011 as a fundraiser, we started this Northern California Soy and Tofu Festival. Somewhat based upon this tofu dessert competition we had at the old Nichi Bei Times in 2009, but also in spirit of the LA Tofu Festival, which lasted for 12 years and it no longer exists. But we do this to educate the public on the benefits of soy and tofu, but we've turned it into a fundraiser, and we're able to, you know, use that to supplement our revenue streams. American community, well, it's evolving, and we got to find a way to keep people connected, find new innovative ways to keep younger people engaged. Some things that we're looking at as well, whether it's a digital edition, whether it's a website that we've created, a Japanese American news and cultural site, nichibei.org, taking advantage of social media. Our main goal is to keep people connected, giving people access to history, culture, and community. So that's what, you know, our main mission is. The community itself is changing. If you look at the census, you could see on one hand that the population of Japanese Americans is shrinking, but on the other hand, if you look at the multicultural numbers, and that's what I tend to subscribe to, is that it's actually expanding if you include those that are multiracial. So that is why we at the Nichi Bei Times and at the Nichi Bei Weekly, we've done some special editions on multiracial issues. We've done special editions on a green issue. I think we were the Nichi Bei Times was the first Asian American publication in the country to do a focused green issue. So we're trying to do different things that help reach out to different segments of the community. Definitely. Well, the Nikkei press and the ethnic press in general it's there because our stories, our voices are missing from the mainstream press. And there's things that we are able to do, like whether it's to advocate or move along issues of redress, getting redress for certain groups, helping to save Japantown community properties, which, you know, we're credited for providing that voice, that platform. The future of journalism and the future of ethnic journalism, I think, are different. I think we do have a certain niche that is something that mainstream journalism cannot offer.